that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Savior, the hope of a nation. Savior, He can move a mountain. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save forever. Author of salvation, He rose and conquered.
Conquer the grave. Jesus conquered the grave.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up. It's a new day dawning. It's time to sing Your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the
Blessed be your
my heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. You give and take away. You give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name, yeah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name.
Today is the feast of the Ascension. Welcome to St. Margaret de Ville, and greetings to our live-streamed audience. We gather today on the feast of the Ascension. Jesus, in full sight of his disciples, rose up and returned to his Father in heaven, a sure sign of our final destination to be with him in eternity. But we are not alone. God has given us the gift of the Holy Spirit to be our consoler and guide. Meanwhile, we obey his command to go out and make disciples of all nations, spreading the good news of God's love to all. Due to COVID-19 restrictions, all our masses continue to be private and live streamed. Communion is available on Saturday evenings at 5:45 p.m. and Sundays from 9 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. The church is open on Tuesdays and Thursdays for private prayer and meditation. Please call the parish office to make arrangements for masses and other business. Join us at 7 p.m. every day for our live stream novena to the Holy Spirit. Brothers and sisters, open your hearts today and abide in the love of Jesus. Let us now rise and join our presider, Father Roger.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the peace and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to our celebration. We celebrate today the Feast of the Ascension, which almost brings to a close the post-resurrection season, the season of Easter. Next weekend, we celebrate Pentecost, and once again, I invite you to join with me at 7 p.m. as we journey towards Pentecost. We are praying that all the gifts and the fruits of the Spirit may be apparent in our lives, that we will experience love and joy and peace and all that the Spirit has in store for us. So today is like a preparation towards Pentecost. We open our hearts and lives to the promptings, to the guidance and consolation of the Holy Spirit. Today our Mass is being offered for the repose of the souls of Ulrich Perez, Joseph Kane Marcelino Mejia, in thanksgiving for favors received for the Rebello family, in thanksgiving for the birthday of Yoli Villegas, in thanksgiving for the 30th anniversary of Caroline and Bernardo Chavez, for the health of Caroline Chavez, and also in thanksgiving and for the birthday of Yolanda Viegas. Congratulations especially to Caroline and Bernardo, who are celebrating their 30th anniversary, and for our two birthday persons as well, Yoli and Yolanda. My friends, as we gather today to give thanks and praise to Almighty God, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Gladden us with holy joys, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving, for the ascension of Christ your Son is our exaltation. And where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus did and taught from the beginning until the day he was taken up to heaven. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen, after his suffering, he presented himself alive to them by many convincing proofs, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While staying with them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. This, he said, is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. So when they had come together, they asked him, Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel? He replied, it is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going, and they were gazing up toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you see him go into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God mounts his throne to shine.
The second reading is taken from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that with the eyes of your heart, excuse me, so that with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power. God put his power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, and fullness of him who fills all in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. Jesus appeared to the 11 and he said to them, "Go out into the world and proclaim the good news to the whole creation. The one who believes and is baptized will be saved, but the one who does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will accompany those who believe. By using my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak in tongues. They will pick up snakes in their hands. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not hurt them. They will lay their hands on the sick, and they will recover." So when the Lord Jesus, after he had spoken to them, was taken up into the heavens and sat down at the right hand of God, and they went out and proclaimed the good news everywhere, while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the message by the signs that accompanied it, the Gospel of the Lord. We have some very intense readings before us today. The first reading from the book of Acts that tells us that Jesus, in full view of his three closest friends, Peter, James, and John, rose up from their midst, and their normal human reaction was to feel neglected, lost, and alone. Their dear friend was leaving them, but Jesus promised to send an advocate who would be their consoler and their guide. There's a message of reassurance that runs through the readings today, more so in the second reading taken from Ephesians, where Paul writes that absolutely nothing on heaven and on the face of the earth, nothing whether spiritual or non-spiritual, can separate us from the love of God made present in Christ Jesus. That everything is in God's hands. Do you believe that? That everything, your smallest problem, And the biggest problem that we can encounter in the world are all in God's hands. History is leading to some sort of finality and culmination. We don't know it, we can't see it. We don't know where it's going. Things seem to be going wrong each day, but everything is in God's hands. God is in charge. And of course, our gospel reading today telling us that in leaving his disciples, God has left us with a mission. He did not just leave and leave us alone. He left us a mission. He told his disciples, and I quote from Mark's gospel, "Go out and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you." And once again, it ends with that message of reassurance. "Behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." That message of reassurance seems to be so timely. Everybody needs to be reassured these days, where people are so uncertain and where we are not quite sure what's going to happen from one week to the other. So Paul's message today from Ephesians, that all things are in God's hands, comes at a very timely time, comes to us in a very timely fashion. Now, when you look at the Ascension, there's a vertical dimension and there's a horizontal dimension. Jesus ascends to heaven and the church goes out to share the good news. One goes up and the other one goes out. The specific task that is entrusted to the church is to be a witness. What is a witness? A witness is someone who has first-hand information. An accident occurred at the corner of Sandalwood Parkway and Torbram, and you were there on site. You saw what took place. So your testimony is very valuable. And this is why we hold the writers of the gospel in such high regard, because they witnessed what Jesus said and what he did. This is why we go back to the New Testament to understand the shape of our church today. This is where baptism and communion and confirmation and confession come from. It comes from people who had direct access to Jesus. To give you an example of what I'm talking about, people sometimes question the practice of infant baptism in the Catholic Church. Where did the church get that from? If baptism is supposed to mean a change in life and a change in thinking, a baby cannot change their life and their way of thinking. It's just a baby. Hasn't committed any sins yet. So why does the church baptize babies? It's because of Acts 16, 33 and 34. The church wants to practice what was done before. We want to stay honest with what happened in the Bible. And the Bible tells us in Acts 16, 33 and 34 that the practice was to baptize entire families together. The father got baptized, the mother got baptized, the children got baptized, the slaves and servants in the house got baptized as well, and the babies and infants also got baptized as well. Baptism was never the preserve only of adults in the church. So if anybody asks you about infant baptism, take them back to Acts 16, 33 and show them that the Bible states in no uncertain terms that entire families got baptized together, and the church has continued this practice. But more important than that is the idea of being a witness. What do we give witness to? We give witness to the love and power of God in our lives. There's infancy Catholicism and there's adult Catholicism. You know what infancy Catholicism is? Infancy Catholicism is where somebody comes to church out of duty. Infancy Catholicism is someone who comes to church just to ask God for things. But adult Catholicism is to witness to the love and power of God in your life, to share your testimony with others, to tell people that this is my story, this is what God has done for me, and he can do that for you as well. And this is how we give witness to the power and love of God in our lives. I want to ask us today, what is the quality of your witness? What do people have to say about you? Are there ambiguities and contradictions in your life so that when people look at you, they're not quite sure that you are really a follower of Jesus, because they see some good, but they see a lot of negatives as well. The picture is kind of fuzzy. The quality is not quite there. Ascension is an invitation to get rid of these contradictions, to let go of certain areas in our lives that we have not yet given to God. Our witness might be a bit, to use a common term, vaiki-vai. We are going in two directions at the same time, and we are not quite sure that we really want God to have everything that we are and everything that we profess. I have often quoted the words of Teresa of Avila here in her beautiful poem, "Christ Has No Body But Yours." And it is quite true. If you want to be a witness, you need to give him your hands and your feet and your eyes and your entire self, because we represent Christ in today's world. We are the abiding presence of God here on the face of this earth. And when people look at us, they should be able to see the love and power of God manifest in our lives. This is part of the message of the Ascension. We tend to stress the Jesus going up, but the other part of the Ascension is the church going out to witness to the good news. I want to wish all of you a happy Ascension feast day. I want to pray that you may be a powerful witness, that you may be able to bring many to God through your witnessing to him. And remember the words of St. Francis of Assisi, where he says, "Go out and preach the good news and use words if necessary." So it is your life that will give witness more than what you say. Amen. Please stand as we profess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our hope is in our risen Lord. Confident that God will hear our prayers, we pray, we place our needs before him.
For the church, that she may affirm and strengthen all members to lead a life worthy of the calling received to build up the body of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in positions of authority, that they may be guided by the Lord's heavenly wisdom, so that all may be served with dignity and justice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In these days leading to Pentecost, that we may unite in prayer and ask God for a new outpouring of the Holy Spirit on the St. Margaret Duville family. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the lonely, and the grieving, that they may find consolation through Christ's abiding presence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the personal intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, and for whom this Mass is offered, for the repose of Alaric Pyrrhus, the repose of Joseph Kane, the repose of Marcelino Megilla, and in thanksgiving for the favors received for the Ribello family, in thanksgiving for the birthday of Yoli Villegas, in thanksgiving for the 30th anniversary of Caroline and Bernardo Chavez, and for the health of Caroline Chavez. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they may share in the joys of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of glory, as we commemorate this day when your Son Jesus was exalted in great triumph, hear our petitions and send us your Spirit of truth. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
In the eyes of my heart, I'm
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realm. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he has led and founder has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, we sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share with each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
An act of spiritual communion. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. We can call on that name in all our troubles and difficulties. Just a reminder that every evening until Saturday, next weekend, we will be continuing with our Holy Spirit Novena. So come out, beautiful music, live worship style music as well, praise and worship. We pray for the gifts and the fruits of the Spirit for all of us. I really want these fruits and gifts to be manifest in our lives. God knows we need them at this time. And we pray for an outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon our parish community. We want a Spirit-filled community here at St. Marguerite Duville. So come out. Our topic for this evening is the topic of piety. What is piety? Do we need piety in our lives? So please come tune in at 7 p.m. Go to the parish webpage and click on the live stream link at 7 p.m. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who allow those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Savior, keep